stupid ass. Come on, man. Get your ass. Come on, man. Come on, man. Get up. Get out the truck.
I thought I told you about trying to pull stunts on the boss. Now you got him real pissed off.
Man, I don't know what you talking about.
You don't know what I'm talking about.
No, I don't.
So how you think the news got out about the boss's business, bro?
You know what? I can go ahead and make sure this nigga won't say nothing to nobody no more.
That's what you need to do.
Oh, man. I told you. One more word. One more word.
Tell him again.
My pleasure. What?
Come on, man.
You're gonna say I don't?
Huh? You better be glad we got strict orders to bring your punk ass back. You lucky boy.
Was that good for you? Huh? Was it good? Huh?
Oh, man.
Want another one? You take care of him now. How about that? Talk to him.
Get up.
Yeah.
Get up, boy.
Yeah.
Get up.
Yeah. Feeling good about yourself? Huh?
Come on, man. Huh?
Let me tell you something. Look into my eyes. Look, when I'm gonna have my money? When I'm gonna have my money?
Give me a week, man.
Give me a week.
I just need one week.
One week?
One week, man, please.
2 weeks.
Just one week, man.
That's what it's gonna do.
Come on, man.
Okay. Let me tell you something. You can make it real easy for yourself, or you can make it real hard. You got a week. Just a week. If you don't have my money, I'm not gonna even tell you what we're gonna do to you.
I swear.
Okay.
I swear I'm gonna have it, man.
You gonna have it.
I got you, man. One week. I'm gonna have it next week. Come on, man. Just let me go.
Okay.
Get out the truck.
Yeah, just like that. Just like that. Remember that, young man. Remember that. Remember that, okay? Remember that. Okay? Remember that.
You take them out of here, boss.
Hey, take that trash out of here. Take that trash out of here.
Good thing my mama raised me right, because I just be wanting to hurt somebody sometimes.
People worry about me and mine. Trust and believe, there's nothing wrong with my son. He don't need no special help. Ain't nothing wrong with him. Allie! Allie!
What? When did you get here?
You didn't hear anything I just said?
No, I'm sorry. I'm in my own little world right now.
Clearly. What's wrong with you? You okay?
Nothing. I'm just thinking.
Okay. Well, if you need anything, just let me know. It's not out of it. Everything's gonna be fine. I'm sure of it. I need some coffee.
You know what? The water's been cut off, but I could get you some bottled water. Yeah, I'll be back.
Okay, I'm about to call them right now. See, this is why I knew I was gonna have a bad day. But no, I gotta go help people. Can't even get my coffee. That's crazy. Hello? Hello? Allie, the phone isn't working. Allie, do you hear me talking to you?
Yes, Tessa, I hear you. And soon, the lights will be off too.
What? What happened? I thought we had the monies coming in from the grant that we applied for.
We do, and I just didn't know that it was going to take this long for us to get it. I don't know if I can keep doing this anymore. How can I help other people? I can't even help myself.
Yo. Yes, man. No, I can't pay you tomorrow. I know what we promised, man, and I can have it for you next week. No, I cannot do it tomorrow. Look, something came up, man, and I can't meet you tomorrow. Yes, I know how important it is. 5 days, man. I just need 5 days, and I'll have the money. Come on, man. I promise. All right, later.
We got a lot of people coming to this renaming ceremony. What are we going to do with all these people with no phone and no water?
Tessa, I really don't know.
Well, you'll figure it out. I'm sure you will. You're like some superwoman or something.
I don't know about this time.
Well, maybe you should ask David. He might know what to do about all this. After all, he is the financial professional around here.
You might be right. Maybe I will give him a call. I'm gonna go into my office room and I'll be back.
Girl, all this is making my head hurt.
Girl, everything makes your head hurt.
Look what the cat done drug in. Probably want something.
Whatever, girl. You know you need to stop fronting. You know you want this.
Boy, please, nobody wants you.
Oh,
you
hold up.
You got nothing to offer.
Hold up. Did you just call me a boy, little girl?
Little brother.
Hey,
how
sis.
Are you? I know you didn't come here to start no mess, so you... wait, is everything okay with Mom?
Relax, Allie. Mom is fine.
Whew, okay.
But I kind of need your help with something.
What else is new?
Hey, how about you shut up and mind your business? Don't you have some papers or something you can be filing way over there?
Let me tell you something. What you need to do, you need to stop coming around here asking, begging for money all the time.
Two of you, stop. Just stop. Parker, what is it? I'm a little bit busy. What do you need?
As I was saying, I got into a little bit of trouble with the track, and I kind of overextended myself.
What happened, Parker?
Well, I know I told you I'd never do it again, but my boy Morgan, he told me it was a sure thing. He said I couldn't lose.
Hold on. Let me get this straight. Make sure we're all on the same page. You talking about Morgan, my ex?
Tessa.
Okay, hold on. The Morgan that just got out of jail from being in some Ponzi scheme?
Tessa.
Okay, hold on. The same Morgan, you spent all your money on this little stupid little t-shirt business all because he got some kind of tip about the Olympics coming to Raleigh?
Okay, Tessa. All right. Thank you. I think we all know which Morgan he's talking about. Go ahead, Parker.
Thank you. As I was saying, I did win. Morgan was right.
Oh, that, Good news. I'm glad. So what does that have to do with me?
Well, I know I should have stopped after I won. Mm-hmm. But I felt like I could keep winning and winning and winning. Didn't happen that way. I mean, they even gave me credit, sis, and I lost that too.
I'm so sorry for you. That's terrible. But let me ask you again. What does it have to do with me?
Well, from what I know, if I don't pay them what I own, it's going to be a pretty bad day for me.
I know you're not coming to me for money.
Come on, Allie.
Come on what? What do you want from me? I don't have any money.
Allie, please. It's only $20,000 and you always help me out. Don't give up on me now.
Only $20,000? Okay, I know you have lost the little bit of mind that you have left. And you're right. You said it perfectly. I always help you. I always help you get out of these messes that you never seem to understand how to get yourself out of. Before, you used to always go to Mom. But now that Mom can't help you, now you come to me. Well, I can't help you anymore.
But Allie, I promise.
You promise what? I can't keep doing... I don't have any money. I have no money, Parker. I can't help you.
Look, I need this time. And I swear to you, after this, I'll go get some help.
Oh, yes. I'm sure you will swear that you'll go get some help. You always swear that you will go get some help. But you never get help. You keep making the same mistakes, Parker. Look, I cannot help you. If you notice, I'm trying to run a center here, and I can hardly do that. I need to go. I need to take care of some business. But I'll tell you one thing. When I get back, you better be here, you better be on time for the ceremony, and you better be looking good. Got it?
Yes, Al.
Leave it up to you to make things all negative-like.
Oh, Sam. Thank you for meeting me here on such short notice. Mm.
Anything for you, Allie. Anything. You know, me and your father used to meet here. I declare your father was one of the best business partners I've ever worked with. But these young boys do think a little bit differently than we did back in the day.
Is everything okay at the office? I mean, Rick says everything's great.
You know, Allie, sometimes people think they know what's best. I trust that your father knew what he was doing when he gave Rick the seat. He knew how to run a business and how to keep it running smoothly.
You know how my father was. He was always about business and always about making that money.
That he was. I miss him. Much.
Me too. Not a day goes by that I don't think about him.
You know what? That's why it's good to see you, because you remind me so much of him.
Thank you, Sam. You always know what to say to make me feel better. Which is why I called on you. I need you to look over things, just to make sure everything's on the up and up. I brought this for you. I need you to review it for me.
What is this?
Just look it over. And when you find out anything, just let me know. Give me a call. But I have to get back and take care of the ceremony. But do call me when you find out anything, okay?
What is this, Al?
Sam, just review it, see what you find, and call me. I have to get back to the center for the ceremony, but whatever you find, just call me as soon as possible.
Yeah, but what...
Oh, thank you so much, Sam. Thank you very much. I'll talk to you soon.
Allie.
Thank you. Bye.
Corey, I sure hope you knew what you were doing. Yeah, this is Sam Link. Where you at? Yeah, well, I think we have a serious problem. I'll be there.
The talking about?
What you in here dancing around acting so ratchet for? Let me let you know something. The mother of my kids shouldn't be up in here acting like that. In here dancing around like you drunk or something. Woman, you know this is a place of business.
First of all, when did you get so business-minded? Secondly, no ex of mine should be showing up unannounced. What you want anyway?
Well, dang. What's up with all the unnecessary attitude? I mean, can't a man come visit his friend in peace?
Sweetie, I am not your friend.
Baby girl, I wasn't talking about you. Talking about Parker. Where he at anyway?
Yo, Morgan, what's going on, man?
What's up, man?
Ain't nothing.
I'm looking for you, bro.
Word. You ready to get up out of here, man?
I'm ready. Let's get it.
Let's go.
Where you about to go?
Wouldn't you like to know? It's your nosy self.
Whatever it is, it's probably illegal anyway. I'll just read about it in the paper.
That mouth of yours is going to keep you single for a long time, Tessa.
Sure is.
And that record of yours is going to keep you jobless for a long time.
You see what I be talking about, bro? Why you got to take it there?
Parker, remember Allie said you need to be here on time for the ceremony.
Look, I'm going to be here. Don't worry about that. And who you supposed to be, her messenger girl or something?
That nose is looking a little brown right now.
Right.
Okay. You two make a perfect match. Dumb and dumber.
Look, whatever. Look, man, you can stay here and entertain this foolishness if you want to. I got a phone call to make, so I'll be out here by the car, man. Hang it, man.
My bad. I'll be out there. All
right.
Look, I need to talk with you anyway.
You need to be making sure that school is taking care of my kids and not doing whatever it is that they want to do.
What are you talking about?
Man, Tessa, come on. You know what I'm talking about. You know they're a little too young to really tell us anything right now. What I need you to do is make sure that you're going down to that school every single day and making sure that those teachers is giving my kid the best education.
Hold on. Wait. Are you really trying to tell me what to do with my son? May I remind you who's been absent for 2 years?
And I guess you're just not going to never let me lay that down, are you?
Yay! Finally, you get something right. How you going to be gone for 2 years and try to jump back in and pick up where you left off without putting in work? You want to be a father? How about you go up to the school every single day and talk to his teachers one by one? Then you can come and give me orders.
Man, come on, Tessa. You know I work.
I'm sorry. Did you say work? Oh, I'm about to call child support right now.
See, there you go. You know what? I can't even deal with your dramatics. Forget it. I'm about to go.
Now you ready to leave? You supposed to go 5 minutes ago. And then as soon as I mention child support, you ready to roll up out of here?
Tessa, don't do this today, man. You know I want to take care of my kids. It's
hard right now because I'm only kind of working little side jobs for people and I can't really claim that 9-to-5 like I want
to. It's hard. Yeah, I know it's hard, Morgan. You want to know how I know? Because I do this every single day. Ugh. Excuses. If only us mothers can use the same excuse that you lame daddies use.
But Tessa, you know I...
Please leave, Morgan. I ain't got nothing else to say to you.
Bye, baby.
I am not your baby.
You know I'm always had love for you, though, right?
Whatever.
Can you at least tell my kids that daddy will see them later?
No. Because when you don't come... I would be the one to have to deal with their disappointment. Not you.
Yeah, man. We ought to be there in about 15 minutes, man. Yeah, I know. Oh, trust me, man. I know how important this is. Hey, well, yo, here he comes. I'm about to be out. All right.
So, man, my bad. Baby mama be tripping.
That's all right,
man. Ah, but, you get that set up?
Come on, man. You know I did. Easy money, baby.
My man. So what are we waiting on? Let's go get it.
All right. Whoa, hold up. Did you tell that loudmouth baby mama of yours anything?
Parker. Come on, man. It's me. Do I look stupid to you, bro? All
right, man. Let's get this money.
All right. Come on, man.
Mrs. Baxter.
Hello.
I am really sorry I didn't get a chance to get back in touch with you, but you certainly didn't have to come down here.
It's all right. It's no worry.
How can I help you?
Mrs. Gray, I understand that you are filing to take complete control of the center from your mother.
Yes. Unfortunately, she's been very sick. There's no way she can...
very sorry to hear that, but you should know that your mother hasn't been keeping up with things as she should have over the past few years. There's gonna need to be a lot of work done to the place before we can even consider doing.
That's okay. I understand. I'm willing to do whatever it takes. We just need to get it done.
Look, Mrs. Gray, I understand that you want to save the center, but I don't think you understand the intensity of the work that needs to be done. We're talking legal fees and repairs to bring the building up to code, and with those repairs come contractor costs. It could cost as much as, if not more, than the center is even worth. Honestly, if you ask my opinion, I really think that you should close it down.
Mrs. Baxter, I can't do that. These kids depend on this center. Now, I'm willing to do anything and everything it takes to keep these doors open.
Even if you get all of this work done, I just don't even know if this is going to be possible.
And I'm willing to do whatever it takes. Look, like I said, there are people that care and depend on this center. You know, today we're going to have a renaming ceremony. I really think you should be there.
I'll see if I can fit it into my schedule.
Thank you. I appreciate it. I will look forward to seeing you there tonight.
Okay.
You have a wonderful day, Miss Baxter.
You too.
Thank you.
Ken Morgan, get on my nerves. I was with him the other day. He's trying to act like he's a father of the year. We all know you're deadbeat dad. He just got out of jail. Yeah, girl. Girl got to go.
Are you on the phone again?
I'm sorry, I just got off.
Did I just see Parker leaving with Morgan?
Yes.
Oof, he better not be late tonight. I can tell you that now.
Oh. So where you been? We've had a lot of miracles happen around here, and you weren't even here to witness them.
Tessa, what are you talking about?
Oh, the sky opened up, and the Lord said, "Let there be water." Next thing you know, the water was running. And then moments later, I hear the sweet sounds of a ringing phone.
That was no miracle, sweetheart. Shoot, that was simply me paying the bills.
Shoot, sound like one to me. Because this morning, you ain't even had the money to pay that. Ain't that right?
Yeah, well, whatever. I'm going to be in my office. If anybody asks me at all, I am so not here. I need a break.
I got you,
girl. You got that?
I got you.
Does that mean me too?
Oh, hey, honey. Tessa? Why didn't you tell me Rick was here?
Allie, Rick's here.
Are you kidding me?
Did you really think I wouldn't find out what you were doing?
Excuse me, what are you talking about?
I had a meeting with Mr. Morris today.
Our accountant?
My accountant.
Tessa, would you please excuse us for a moment?
Sure, girl. Give me a holler when you need me.
Yes, Tessa. Please excuse us, because my wife here has some pressing matters that she has to explain to me.
Thank you, Tessa.
Girl, you know I got your back.
Right, thank you. Look, I don't know what you think you know, but it is not what it looks like.
Oh, really?
Yes. Really, Rick?
Well, what it looks like to me, Allie, is that my open, honest, truthful wife is stealing from me and now trying to cover up her tracks.
Okay, wait a second. How do you think I can steal from you?
That's the same conclusion that I come up with, Allie. But you want to, the funny thing is, records don't lie.
Look. Whatever money is in our account is our money. You know I put a lot of money away when I was working. You're just mad because I stopped working when Mom got sick and asked me to take over this center. But you are not going to stand there and tell me that I have to ask you every time I take a little money out of our account.
Excuse me? A little money? Come on, Allie. This is not a little money that we're talking about here. You've been taking $5,000 a month, out of the account. How long did you think that can go on?
What is $5,000, Rick?
You spend that much on your continuous golf outings.
Woman, you know that's for my clients, and I get every cent of that money back. But the question remains, when are you gonna put some money back into the account? Because sweetheart, for the last 3 months, not one deposit, not one dime has come from you.
Look, these things take time, Rick. I'm working on it. Look, we have a big grant coming in, and when that happens, I'll be able to pay myself back.
Pay yourself back?
Yes.
No, sweetheart, you mean pay me back.
Rick, this is not just your money.
Allie, until you go back to work and stop playing around in this godforsaken center, it is my money going into that account. Which means I get to manage it, regulate it, and spend it the way that I want to, not you.
I think you have lost your mind. Do you really think that I'm gonna allow you to just treat me any such way?
Allow? You don't have to allow me to do anything, because everything has already been done. As of tomorrow, you're cut off. In order for you to get anything out of the bank, I have to approve it.
Oh no. No, that is not the case at all, because you are gonna get on the phone with Mr. Morris and turn that around right now.
Wait on it. Now, let's see how many bills get paid at this center on my dime. Late, Allie. It's already done. Remember when your mother got sick and I told you to get rid of this money pit? Did you listen to me? No, you didn't. You want to know why? Because you never do.
But what about all the people that are depending on this center? And you were one of the very boys that needed our help.
That was then. This is now.
Oh. I see. Now you're Mr. Big Shot. And you want me to turn my back on him too? But I'm not. Not Rick! I see how the elite forget where they came from.
Is that supposed to mean something to me, Allie? Because you're right. The only thing I care about is my money, not this stupid center. Everything that I got was from my hard work and talents, not yours.
You disgust me! You worked, didn't do anything. It was all my daddy's hard-working talent. You didn't earn anything at all. My father practically handed you his farm on a silver platter.
I swear you pissed me off with that.
With what, Rick?
You know what, Allie? Every time you don't get your way, you want to throw in the daddy card. And I'm sick and tired of it.
Well, it is what it is, Rick.
Yeah, it's a damn lie. That's
it
what
is. It
not,
is. Not, you know it.
I earned my way from the mailroom to the boardroom while you were out shopping and spending money, which is the only good thing you know how to do. So don't get it twisted. And while your father was out there handing things out on a silver platter, why didn't he just hand it all over to you, sweetheart? I mean, you're his daughter, right? Exactly.
I can't handle it.
I can't handle you right now, Allie. Look, after this ceremony, I'm going away for a few days on business. But I highly suggest that you take this time to decide whether you want me or whether you want this center.
Dad, how long do I have to sit in the car?
Come give Mom a hug.
Mom, I'm like on the phone. Girl, my dad is so right. My mother's so needy.
Listen, Miranda Gray! You will not talk about me that way. All right, go ahead. Go back in the car.
Why always be tripping, Mom?
What did I just say? Get back in the car!
Dad!
I'll see you at home.
I hope not.
What?
Go ahead, sweetheart. I'll be out in a second.
I cannot believe that just happened.
Well, yeah, look, I'm taking Lizzie over to my mother's house later today. She'll be there until I get back from my trip. But like I said to you before, you really, and I mean really, need to take this time to think about your future.
Look, what goes on between us stays between us. Lizzie doesn't ever have to hear a thing about it. My daughter will respect me even if you don't.
Number one, don't hit me. And you want to talk about respect? You'll get respect when you earn it.
You need to keep your opinions to yourself!
Allie, listen to me very closely. And trust me when I say this. You are in no position to make demands. Understand? Gotta go.
Will you be at the ceremony tonight?
Why not? The only thing this center is good for is free publicity. For me.